Paul writes a wonderful book from prison. It's often called the Book of Joy because he mentions joy so many times. And yet he's going to tell us, I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has actually served to advance the gospel. What's that? You got a bigger church, bigger income, more converts. No, listen. As a result, it has become clear throughout the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ. And because of my chains, most of the brothers and sisters have become confident in the Lord and dare all the more to proclaim the gospel without fear. Isn't that amazing? I would think if I was around a man that got in prison for doing something, I wouldn't want to do it. And here Paul is saying, because I'm in jail, I'm chained to a soldier. Many times they were chained. Someone said he began a chain reaction as he kept leading people in the Praetorian Guard to Christ. Here he is saying, hey, this is working for the furtherance of the gospel. The brothers and sisters are saying, if Paul is willing to put his life on the line and go to jail for the message that he's delivering, the one that saved us, it's emboldening them. I think we keep trying to find a pain-free way to make Christ known in this world. And yet Jesus said in John, hate will come from a lost world. Many times when we're making Christ known, we're not welcome. I've been reading the life of Adoniram Judson, who went to Burma in the 1800s, buried two children, buried a wife, thrown in jail, health issues. It was not easy, but there's a church of over 300,000 people in Burma today. We want that, but we want pain-free impact. Will they turn me down? He said, my suffering for Christ is emboldening my brothers and sisters. Let me say this to you. We are free while we're so-called chained. Here he is. We sing a song sometime in our church called I Bless Your Name. And there's a stanza that goes, in prisoner's chains in your mind. And I'm amazed at how it goes through the congregation. And I asked my wife, why does that song penetrate hearts? And she simply said, because people's minds are chained. They're in fear. They're in pain. They're in anxiety. And they may not shake off a physical chain, but they come chained inside. They're full of maybe bitterness, the past, pain, on and on, up here the mind. And here Paul is the freest man in prison. The freest man is the guard that's really in chains. He's chained to eternal destiny without Christ, unless this so-called captive, this so-called prisoner, can tell him how to get out of the chains that are wrapped around his soul. You know, in the final day, it said that Satan shall be chained and thrown into the lake of fire to bother the nations no more. Let me say to you, if you're in the chains of fear and doubt and fear the future, Jesus Christ will break the fetters. You could be in prison and watching and listening to this, and he will break your chains inside that you may walk out free as the slave of Christ and free from the chains of your sin.